I recently posted a video regarding my screen that I use to work on all day, and I had a few questions regarding resolution. So I wanted to make a video to demonstrate how I record videos to ensure that the resolution makes sense for most users. So recording in a resolution like 1920 by 1080. So if that sounds interesting and you've been working with a wide monitor and want to share videos, check out the rest of this video. All right, so we are now in my desktop, or on my desktop rather. As you can see, I am sharing a fully wide version of my desktop. So this is 3440 by 1440. So this is what you would normally see if you were just to hit screen record in something like Camtasia. I have it formatted down to 1920 for this video, but you can record at that full resolution and someone on a different size monitor will get weird results. So this is kind of what you would see. In the case of something like Revit, if I open it, it would be full screen. So if you're working in Revit yourself, not recording videos, this is really nice. This is actually kind of awesome because you do have all of this real estate. I prefer one wide monitor over two monitors. I actually have a vertical monitor as well for a bunch of other stuff. But this is no good if you want to record that for sharing with other people. So there is a free tool from Microsoft. It is called PowerToys. If you just Google search PowerToys, and I'll actually include a link to it below as well, you will see that it has a bunch of different features. So it has features like forcing windows to always be on top, features to help your computer stay awake, color pickers, things like that. One of my favorite is this highlight mouse cursor. So if you hit control twice, the left control key, it will highlight your mouse cursor for you. But where this really gets interesting is a plugin called FancyZones. So if I hit Windows key tilde on my keyboard, I will see that I have this little config UI for both of my monitors. In this case, I have a horizontal main recording, horizontal main, which is more full screen. So in the event that I'm recording a video, I actually turn around and I will use this main recording. And now as I drag Windows and hold down the Shift key, it will dock to a resolution that makes sense. So what I'll do is I'll go ahead and toggle to this view here as well. So this is more what you would see as a viewer of a video. You would see a 1920 by 1080 resolution at this point. What's really great is if you were working within Revit, for instance, and you needed to dock other windows around. So if you have like external plugins, you can actually dock those as well in a similar way. So let's switch back to this wide and we'll drag our project browser out and hold down Shift. We'll do the same thing for our properties and hold down Shift. And now you can see that those have docked next to Revit as well. This is a really nice way to work. I work like this in Visual Studio, but we'll put those back for now. And then we'll jump back to the regular one. Other than that, this tool really helps out. You can set up several different configurations, add hotkeys and all sorts of stuff. There's a column setup. You can overlap layouts, things like that. So yeah, a lot of different options in here. If I hit on the pencil icon here, we will see that the center one is 1920 by 1080. The other ones are kind of different resolutions, but that ensures that any kind of video that I make makes sense for most viewers. So yeah, there you have it. FancyZones, really cool tool to get. It's free. It's on GitHub. It's open source. There's actually a feature request in there right now. I'm using an older version because child windows that belong to a parent program are acting a little weird in the latest version. So hopefully they fix that soon, but I'm on 5.1, I think, for the version. But yeah, check it out. It's a really cool set of tools. Give it a try and see if it helps in your workflow.